All right. I'm probably gonna have mulligan this hand. No action. This hand is good. I'm on the draw. I can Mystical Tutor for Buried Alive and just have all the fun. I mean, I also want to just be able to play turn two Fact or Fiction. Gotta stay competitive. I'm assuming this person has a lot of trophies. No, I'm gonna bottom this. I mean, I already have a makeshift mannequin in my hand. Like, unless my opponent's playing an aggressive deck. But I'd rather be able to just draw an untapped land. Oh, come on. Stay competitive in the race drafting your mono red decks? Pfft. Whatever. Respect lost. All right, well, we're probably in trouble. Okay, you know what? All right, never mind. There's blue in here. Respect gained. My tap lands are ruining me. Why? Why do you do this to me? So about that living death. Well, we don't actually have a black source either, so it's not gonna be great. Wrong one. Wrong one. Do I have the Mystical Tutor for Time Walk? No, that doesn't do anything. I mean, it gives me another land drop if I find a land. But like this Koth Emblem is gonna beat me, so maybe I do want to just take that extra. Oh no, never mind. That doesn't change anything at all. Well, no, it does. So if I'm Mystical Tutor for Time Walk, I know I'm drawing Time Walk, but it allows me to play my Sheldak Isle and then maybe give me another. Then I have a chance of drawing a land for Silumgar. Like what else? Oh no, I can actually just get yeah, no, that's better actually. I can get Frantic Search. And hope my opponent does have a burn spell. Oh my god. But this is actually like we have it on the board, so let's play that for the mana. Let's go Living Death, any order. Frantic Search. So we're gonna have. Ooh! I can just hard cast the Silumgar, which is better. We're gonna have 4 mana, 3, 6. So I discard Island. And I guess Makeshift Mannequin? I think Foth is. Well, actually. Yeah, Foth is probably better than Makeshift Mannequin. Then we do this. This way, like, there's not a lot of removal spells that a blue-red deck will have for Dragonlord Silumgar. And we'll do that. Okay. We're getting domed. I mean, we're probably, to be honest, we're still probably losing to the Shrine of Burning Rage. Like, I need to find a way to get Gristlebrand on the board. Okay, so one extra point of damage there. Sure. Is there any way for me to get that shrine off the board? Oh yeah, I can hit Terastodon. Mox Ruby. Wow. My opponent's deck is sweet. Alright, so we foff here. So I have a Living Death. Interesting. What's in my opponent's hand there? The thing is, let's see. We're on 27. Wait, let's count our permanents here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So this will make it 22. And then if I draw a card, it'd be 21. If I take the Buried Alive stack, yeah, definitely. All right. I can actually Living Death, but I will take a damage. Oh, that's perfect. I actually don't want to attack because my opponent might chump. Terastodon, Gristlebrand, Consecrated Sphinx. Oh, this is so sick. This is so awesome. Okay. So certainly the shrine. And I think an island. And yeah. All right. And let us pass. Wow, what a comeback. What a comeback. That was insane. Just every game, Soul Ring, thank you. But that was an insane fact into Foff into, oh. This is what Cube is all about. All this time I've been drafting fair decks and I could have been doing this. Oh my goodness. All right, let's go Batterskull, Spellskite. Blade Maggot's not great. Necrotal, I guess. Diabolic Edict. I just want as much like early interaction as possible. I think I'm gonna board out Mana Confluence for just like a basic land. Probably a swamp. Take this out. Cause I think we're just trying to grind our opponent out a little more after sideboard, so like I can take out a card like the careful the Mystical Tutor. Although the Mystical Tutor has been pretty great. I don't know. Maybe I'm just like overboarding, if that's possible. Can probably cut Force of Will in this matchup, because like all their cards kind of do the same thing for the most part. I mean, I like my reanimation spells. Cut Thoughtseize, keep an Inquisition. I like having two Living Deaths though, so maybe I want to keep the Mystical Tutor. Gotta cut two more cards here. I feel like Looter Ilkor will never live, so maybe we cut that. Well, that's the same argument for Packrat, though. This is like five. We have six discard outlets, but I do like having a million discard outlets. Maybe I don't need the Necrotal. No, Necrotal seems good. Ugh. All right, fine, whatever. I'll. Jeez. Okay. You know what? It's worked for us in the past. Man, it's the Sol Ring draw, but no black mana. Yeah, we're just not guaranteed to be able to do anything at all that game. You know, with the careful study, I'm really looking for like a reanimation spell. So, I don't know. At the same time, Spellskite is just kind of a pretty good blocker. But you know what? I'm going to bottom this. I don't know exactly how aggressive my Deponent's deck is. But I don't think it's going to get to the point where I'm like hard casting my Consecrated Sphinx, so I can only Mystical Tutor for Makeshift Mannequin or I can only makeshift man, Mystical Tutor for Makeshift Mannequin or Living Death. My opponent just has a million burn spells? Uh-oh. Pestermite. I don't think I have another reanimation spell. Necromancy? I can't get necromancy. Alright. The cough. Oh, it's the Splinter Twin! No! Alright. Okay, let's put Force of Will back in. Man. Yeah, I'm actually going to get rid of Looter and Packrat because I don't think they're going to have enough of an impact here because they just get killed right away. So I'd rather go with Careful Study, Frantic Search, Thirst for Knowledge, Liliana to put cards in my graveyard. I mean, I guess Packrat I can play at turn 5 and use it as a discard outlet, but still. Should have kept the Spellskite on top, folks. On top, folks. Huh. This is making me too scared. What's my last card? I just never know. Yeah. Look, it's, you know, we get in the holiday spirit. Just keep it a little loosey-goosey. It's all good. My opponent missed, like, yeah. I thought we had a good chance when my opponent missed the land drop because I thought, you know, they won't be able to just kill me out of nowhere. And then we died out of nowhere. So this doesn't have, like, we need a reanimation spell, but if we draw one, it's pretty great. And we have, like, oh god.
What is this hand? Do we just take Chrome Mox? I mean, Chrome Mox puts my opponent down on resources, but if like my opponent might just not be able to cast anything. Yeah, I'll take Chrome Mox. They could just not have. Of course. Why not? I actually think it's more important for me to discard. My opponent can kill my Liliana, but let's see. No, I guess if, let me think. This is guaranteed to get a Swift Spear off the board though. All right, yeah, let's just do that then. All right, whew. So we will Mystical Tutor for a makeshift mannequin, I guess. Yeah, makeshift mannequin. And then I'm just gonna make a bunch of things. Pay 4 for Mana Vault. No. One. Each player discards card. I think we got this one. But my opponent was very mana screwed. I could have, oh, okay, perfect. Opponent sacrifices elephant and just start getting in. Boom! Good thing I never boarded out that Mystical Tutor, right? Okay, well, that was a pretty quick video, and wow, we actually just got to draft the Reanimator deck, have fun, and pick up our 11th trophy. We get to still stay relevant and be on that first page, and so that is definitely a good feeling. But gotta rack up more trophies. Again, thank you all for watching, and yeah, happy holidays.